So point number one is goal. This is, trust me, the most important point that none of us follow. Even 99% of investors all around the world do not follow this basic principle, which is goal. If you do not have a goal while investing in the stock market, you will never make money from the stock market, because you'll always end up confusing what your target is with what you want. This is the biggest problem. See, all of us are here to make money in the stock market, but how much money and within what time frame is the most important question. For example, let's say I have a trip planned in the next 6 months. Do I need to invest in a company which is giving amazing dividends, is a good company, safe company, but the growth of the company is not that promising in the next 6 months or the next 1 year? Will I invest in that company? Or will I invest in a company which gives me amazing returns, is a good company, but there is no dividend, but the growth potential of the company is very strong? Again, if my horizon is 6 months. Let's say I want to get something in the next 6 months or a year's time, I have to invest in one of the top index stocks, which is a growth company and not a dividend company. Because if it's a dividend company, the return of the stock will not be that promising. It is obvious. We will invest in a stock based on the parameters that I will talk about later in the video. But this is something which you need to understand before we move on to the other points of this video. If we wanted to invest in a company for our portfolio, for a safe portfolio, then it is obvious that we would have invested in the dividend paying stock, because that is a safe bet and we get regular dividends from the company. But like I said, goal becomes the most important criteria for you to pick a stock in the stock market. So let me give you my top 5 strategies, and you can verify them with your logic and your understanding of the stock market, whether these techniques will work or not. Yes, I have never made a loss while investing in the stock market, and this is not a clickbait. I've invested in Suzlon, I've invested in Yes Bank, and still I've made amazing returns from them. So you must be thinking that I am super rich by now. Well, I'm not even close to being super rich. I'm not rich by that matter of fact. But will I be rich someday? Most definitely. Let me talk about the things that I do in the stock market first, and in the next video we talk about the things I do not do while investing in the stock market. If you like the content, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the like button, because that helps us a lot. Second point is quality check. Now this is interesting, because this tells us how do we pick a stock. Now, whenever we want to invest in a stock, we generally do not see the company's basic principles. If you follow the basic principles of a stock and you invest with that principle, you will never lose money. And here are the top 4 techniques that I use while investing in a stock. So the first criteria is that the company should be profitable. Yes, and the most important criteria of all. I would never invest in a company, may it be short term or long term, in a company which is not making profit, as in the company's PL statement should show net profit at least in the last 2 years and in the current year. This is one of my biggest checklists while investing in a stock. Point number 2 is the company's reserves should be at least 3 times of the company's debt, as in if the company has high borrowings, the chance of that company going bankrupt is very high in the future. And if you are an investor who wants to invest in the stock for the next 2 or 3 years, then a company with high debt will have high interest burden. And if the interest burden is high, the company's profit will not reflect positively, and the shareholders in the company or the market stakeholders will not be buying into the share much. So the company's reserve should be at least 3 times higher than the company's debt. I'll make a separate video in which I explain how to read the balance sheet of a company, the PL statement of a company, and other factors which are important while screening a stock. But coming to the third point is that the company's quarterly profit should be positive. If I am a swing trader, or if my positions are for 6 months, then I have to focus on the company's quarterly profits as well. If the company is showing good quarterly profits every quarter, or overall the quarterly profits are consistent, then I would definitely invest in the stock, provided the first 2 criteria are met. Because if the quarterly profits are growing and it's consistent, there is nothing wrong with the company, and the company is bound to go up in price. This plays a very big role while I select stocks for swing trading. And the fourth point is the company's PE ratio, price to earning ratio, should be positive and should be above 8. Now, we investors who are not into fundamental analysis tend to ignore the PE ratio. We just look at them and we say, what is the point of looking at the PE ratio? But it has so much information about the company's projections, the company's outlook, and the market sentiment for the stock. We tend to avoid them altogether. If a company has PE ratio above 8, it is showing that the company has good sentiment in the market. If the PE ratio is below 8, that would mean that investors in the market are not willing to participate in the stock, and the demand of the stock is very little, because PE ratio tells us how much premium we are willing to pay to buy a single share of the company. If the premiums are not good enough, then that would mean that investors are not willing to buy the company's shares. This is why we look at the PE ratio of a company. Now, you can stop the video right now and you can leave, but you'll still make amazing returns from the stock market if you just follow these four techniques of the fundamental factors. But let's talk about other factors which are also very important and the things that I follow, and I never lose money in the stock market. Third point is technical breakouts. Now, when we invest in stock market, we are either technical analyst or fundamental analyst. Very few people have a knowledge of both fundamental and technical analysis. So generally, people will either look at the technical factors and take a position, or they look at the fundamental factors and take a position. Now, the problem here is, if we just look at one of these factors, we will be just average traders in the market or average investors. To be a pro trader or a pro investor, you require both the knowledges, and not proper knowledge of any of these topics. So basic knowledge of these topics is good enough for you to make a very good return in the stock market. I'm not asking you to read big books and study big topics like CFA, FRM degrees. You just require a basic understanding of fundamental and technical factors. Now, for example, in the technical breakout section, if a stock has been in the consolidation phase or a range bound phase for a long period of time, or maybe even a short period of time, and then we see a certain breakout from that zone, that is where we take a position. But we take a position after considering point one and point two, because if we do not have point one and point two in our analysis, then you will not make money by just looking at technical factors. You have to consider both the factors for you to make good money. Now, let me show you a quick example of what I'm talking about in terms of breakouts. You'll see the charts of stocks in the screen right now. This is where, after a breakout, we take a position, provided the first two criteria are fulfilled. And if you want to learn more about how to read a breakout and when is the right time to take a position in technical analysis, you'll get to see a video of that in the description and on the top left hand corner. But this is one of the basic principles of technical analysis which we have to follow if we want to make good money while investing. Now, one quick mention which I would like to talk about is that we have a Telegram page which comes with the stock valuation package, in which you have 10 valuation models together combined in a premium Excel sheet. In that community, we discuss a lot of factors related to the stock market: technical analysis, fundamental analysis, price action trading, cryptocurrency. If you want to be a part of that community, you can check it out. And we have a list of 3 stocks right now, at the time of me making this video, which have the potential to be something in the near future. I'll quickly give you a glimpse of the stock. I do not want you to invest in any of these stocks. Keep it in your watch list and see whether these stocks become multi-baggers or potential stock in which we can see good returns or not in the future. If you do enjoy that, then definitely be a part of the Telegram community and the stock valuation Excel sheet. Moving on, we come to our fourth point, which is target and exit. Now, like I said in the starting of the video, we have a target of 15% of getting a return for swing trading. And I do not take just one position, 1, 2, or even 3 positions from a single script at least once a year. And that is how good the advantage of technical analysis with the fundamental quick check factors help us to make that kind of return. Now, if you are a long-term investor, then you do not require any target, because this is something that you need to understand, that for a long-term investment, I do not know how much the stock will grow, and my objective is to get the maximum return out of it. So unless I see a drop in the company's profits, as in if the quarterly results fall consistently or the company's annual profits fall, then I would exit the stock. Otherwise, I will not exit a stock which I have chosen for long-term, because long-term stocks, you do not know how much return they'll give, but you should be assured that the return that you get is very strong if you follow the quick check factors. And do not be greedy while taking a position in the stock, because at times I've achieved a target of 15% within 2 weeks, but my initial time period was 3 months. So I had to book profit because that is the discipline that I follow while investing. If you see the target price to be achieved very soon, the best thing that you could do is you can exit 70% of your position in that trade and keep 30%. And you can take a risk on the 30%, but you do not take a risk on the 100% of your position on a stock in which you have achieved 15% with this strategy. Because otherwise, the entire profit might go and you might end up making a loss in the market. Now, we have a very interesting video which tells you how to make 15 to 20% return 3 times a year on a single share. You can check the video out on the top left-hand corner. It gives you a lot of insight on how to use technical analysis for stock analysis, right? And finally, point number 5 is market capital. Yes, market capital plays a very big role while we pick a stock for swing trading or positional trading or for long-term investments. Why? Because market capital is something which tells us a lot about a company. How much is the company's safety? How much is the company's dynamics in the market? And what is the market expecting of that stock? Everything you get to know from the market capital. Now, a company which has a very high market capital will give you low returns, but the risk of that will also be very low. So if you invest in a stock which is of higher market capital above 1 lakh crores, then you should know that your return is safe, but the return is also limited, as in you might not get 50 or 60% in those stocks in normal conditions. But if you invest in small or mid-cap stocks, the risk is much higher and the reward is also higher. But remember, in your portfolio, if you are a long-term investor and you want to invest in a company, small cap stocks below 50,000 crores should not cross 25% of your portfolio size, because otherwise your portfolio would be in a lot of risk. We should have 25% of our stocks in small cap stocks, 30 to 40% of our portfolio in mid cap, and 30 to 40% in large cap. You get to decide how much you put in mid cap and large cap, but 25% should be in small cap stocks, not exceeding that. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you had a lot of fun watching it. If you have any questions regarding the things we spoke of, quickly hit on the comment section and write whatever question that you have. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you like the content of this video. And definitely follow us on this channel and the Instagram channel that we have so that you get to know about our latest video. Our next video is about the things that I do not do while I invest in the stock market. So I'll see you guys in the next video, but till then, mind your investment.